Hi, I'm Rongji with Keysight Technologies, and in this video, I'm going to introduce you how to do power amplifier measurement with customized DPD MATLAB scripts in N9055EM0E power amplifier X-app application. So before we start today's topic, one thing I need to mention here, if you are not familiar with DPD theory and Keysight solutions for PA test, please go to the link in the description box at first. There's a video talking about this part in this YouTube channel. As we demonstrated in the former video about DPD models, we know that N9055EM0E PA application supports three embedded typical DPD models: memoryless models such as lookup table, memory model such as Fortran series, and memory polynomial. We are constantly working to update and enhance the software. Good news to let you know, now you can do the PA test with your own customized DPD model written in MATLAB function. Before the demo, we need to check these things prepared for the successful PA test with MATLAB DPD. The MATLAB software should be installed on your signal analyzer. Your DPD MATLAB function file should be formatted correctly for use. Meanwhile, you need to prepare your reference signal file and pay attention that the waveform type should be set to user-defined in N9055EM0E PA application. For the hardware platform, you can pick any solution listed here, but need to pay attention to the firmware version and N9055EM0E application license. As we mentioned before, the key to successful PA test with DPD MATLAB function is need to format your DPD MATLAB function correctly. You need to make sure that your DPD model written in MATLAB scripts should be formatted as shown here, with three input parameters and one DPD output parameters. The name of these parameters should be same as what you set in the N9055EM0E application. Then you can press Extract Function File button to select your DPD model MATLAB file which will be used in the test. Okay, after finish all test preparations, we can start our demo now. I will use the Keysight VXT PXIe vector transceiver here. It integrates the vector signal generator and the vector signal analyzer internally, so it's easy for hardware connection. No external LAN connection here, just need to connect your power amplifier between its RF input and output port. The N9055EM0E PA application is running on the signal analyzer, and it is a window-based application. The instrument is located remotely from me, and because of that, I can use the IP address of the instrument and open a remote desktop session to it, and control it in that way. This is exactly what I've done here. Let's switch to the transceiver screen. First, we need to launch the modular SA applications on the vector transceiver modular by pressing the shortcut of the application, Launch Modular Transceiver. Click on the module number which is existing in the traces we want to use. Then the SA application, or simply called X-app, is launching now. Now let's switch into the N9055EM0E power amplifier measurement application. To do that, click on the tab of the main tab to open up this mode measurement view selector screen. Select power amplifier mode, then power amplifier measurement, and we will keep the normal view because that will work just fine for us. Then press OK. In the power amplifier mode, on the top bar, we can see the information of SG is localhost connected. The trigger is internal. Then let's set our SA carrier frequency at 4.85 GHz. Go to the mass setup, check signal generator RF output is on. Then go to the reference signal tab, select waveform type, user defined. Select the waveform file which we prepared before. Set the sample rate to the 122.88 MHz for the bandwidth 100 MHz signal. Next, let's do the power configuration in the Amplify tab. Set the PA gain to the 16 dB. Power control mode to PA output. PA output power minus 10 dBm and enable power servo. This built-in power servo function will automatically adjust PA output power to be target power within the specified tolerance without using any external program. So restart the measurement. Let's check the measurement standard. Yes, it's correct. So 5DNR, FR1, 100 MHz. We can see the pre-DPD measurement result in yellow color. PA works in the linear region. EVM and ACP results are both good now. Let's look at the demodulated 5GNR signal EVM at first. Switch to the 5GNR mode, select the modulation analysis measurement, press OK. In the 5GNR measurement, set the center frequency at first, 4.85 GHz. Then goes to the mass setup, select mass standard, 100 MHz FR1 TDD, select the test model 1.1 downlink, and press apply preset settings. Then goes to the mass setup time, choose the one subframe analysis, and restore the measurement. Now we can see the constellation diagram is clean for QPSK with EVM 0.28. The 5GNR signal is correct. Actually, you can make the same EVM measurement inside the PA mode. So now let's switch to the PA mode. Go to the PA mass tab, select EVM, set the radio format to 5GNR and 2GNR EVM, press preset from 5GNR. So all the demodulation settings in 5GNR mode are synchronized in the PA mode now. So restart the measurement, then you can get the same 5GNR demodulated EVM results in the PA mode. In order to see the effect of DPD, let's increase power level to make PA work in nonlinear region. So go to Amplify tab and set the output power to the 7 dBm. Then we can restart the measurement. Now we can see PA is in nonlinear region now. ACP and EVM gets worse. Next, go to DPD tab for DPD configuration. Select MATLAB scripts as DPD model. Before we enable DPD measurement, we need to go to settings. Press launch MATLAB. Then the software MATLAB is launching now and will be running in the background. This is one-time operation, so it may take some time. Please wait till the dialog disappears and the message shows MATLAB is connected. Press OK. Now you can go to DPD model configuration to set input-output parameters and record MATLAB function name as we mentioned before. Then enable DPD and restart the measurement. We can see it's now extracting the DPD modeling and the pre-distorted waveform. So you can get your post-DPD results in the blue color. As we can see, delta EVM and demod EVM are both improved, but the ACP has no change. Why does this happen? DPD tries to apply inverse response for nonlinear PA as we previously saw. So the order distortion appears in adjacent channels. So if we want to improve ACPR, the pre-distorted waveform bandwidth also needs to cover adjacent channels. This requires a waveform to have wider bandwidth by applying oversampling. So let's go back to the reference signal configuration to record the oversampled waveform, enable DPD, and restart the measurement. We can see that after applying 3 times higher sample rate, you can get both ACPR and EVM improvement with your MATLAB DPD model. This also means that the measurement instruments such as signal generators or the signal analyzers need to cover higher times of carrier bandwidth. X-app provides power sweep function to step through power levels and measure demod EVM at each power level. Go to settings, press power sweep configuration. You can set start power at minus 10 dBm, stop power 10 dBm, and step size with 2 dBm here. DPD threshold, which is main power level 0 dBm. Then you can enable power sweep, restart the measurement. The EVM vs power measurement will start. You can get EVM vs power curve and metric result with your MATLAB DPD model applied. Meanwhile, power saver function will be performed at each power step here. Attenuation will adjust to range automatically at each power step as well. As we can see, because DPD main power level we set is 0 dBm, so DPD only applied when power level is over this main value. We can do the iteration measurement with your MATLAB DPD model as well. So first, let's switch back to the single power measurement. Then let's go to the DPD tab, set the iteration count to the number 3. Restart the measurement to get the pre-DPD results at first. Then enable DPD and turn on the mass DPD iteration. Then press the restart the DPD iteration button. Then iteration measurement with your DPD model will start automatically. X-app provides DPD, ASP, and EVM results over iterations. This helps you quickly find the best iteration count, which you can optimize settings in the PA test for your DPD MATLAB model. Meanwhile, you can pause the measurement at any iteration step you want. So after doing DPD iteration measurement, you can find the best iteration time is 3 here, because your DPD model gets the best results for the ACP and EVM in this time. Besides those 3 GUI input parameters, N9055EM0E PA application also provides you to add additional input parameters in your DPD MATLAB function for optimizing your model easily. But these additional input parameters can only be configured via the SCPI. X-app provides 4 data types for the additional input parameter. They are string, double, double array, complex array, as listed here. Here are some examples to show you how to define your value. For the complex array parameter, the elements order in array is real value followed by the imaginary value. As we mentioned, the additional parameters value can only be configured via the SCPI command. Here's a SCPI script example. You can do pre-DPD and post-DPD measurement through these commands, same as what we manually do on GUI. As we can see, for those additional parameters configuration, you can go to the input node under DPD source tree, set the value follow the string format, like the first is parameter name, second is your data type, then followed by your parameter value. Now, let's take a look at how it works via the SCPI command. Here's a demo show you can remotely control your instrument, config measurement settings, and get results back. We can see the instrument is connected and the center frequency is modified to 4.85 GHz, the reference signal has been loaded successfully, and we have get back our pre-DPD results. Then the DPD model MATLAB file has been configured, DPD MATLAB function name has been extracted, the input parameters and additional parameters value have been configured, the measurement restart with the post-DPD results. As we can see, it works well, and all the measurements are done automatically via the SCPI command, and we can get our ACP and EVM improvement with this customized DPD model written in your MATLAB scripts. In summary, N9055EM0E PA application characterizes power amplifier with digital pre-distortion in IF and millimeter wave with simple and integrated user interface, which can make both pre-DPD and post-DPD PA measurements. It provides a comprehensive set of tools for demodulation and signal analysis. These tools enable you to measure your DUT in 5G new radio, WLAN, or other wideband PA test scenario with confidence. So to learn more and to download a free trial, visit our CFC's websites. Thanks for watching.